I think you have to ask exactly what it is you want to achieve. Do you want to achieve no infections among kids? Do you want to achieve no transmission within the schools? Because that's an important thing. I mean, you will have cases in schools because kids will become infected outside schools and then bring them in. What you can do in a school is take steps to try and limit transmission. And that has been done quite successfully in some school districts. And there's actually work showing that multiple different interventions like ventilations and masking and so on can be pretty helpful. The issue is that we don't know exactly what Delta will do to that, because Delta is more transmissible. You could see, I mentioned earlier, in the UK, the Office of National Statistics has been publishing regular random samples of different age groups, and you could see that Delta took off very quickly among the adolescents, the high schoolers. Not so quickly among younger kids, and that's always been the case, because the under 10s, the younger children, produce less of the receptor that the virus uses to enter cells. So they are less likely to be infected, even if they can be, and they can transmit, but they're less likely to. So there may well be different things which are appropriate for different age groups. And of course, it will also depend on the state of the pandemic locally, because of the fact that the more infections there are in the community, the more introductions there will be from the community to schools. But as I've said before, it's a very difficult situation. It's one which is going to lead to some very difficult decisions. Those decisions should be made on the basis of the best scientific evidence and while thinking all the time about what you want to achieve.